Hello everybody. In this video we're going to focus on the spark lines and we combine it with a top 10 list. And here you see a detail of it. So I have two top 10 lists. I have a top 10 list of all the customers with their sales, and I have a top 10 of the products with their sales. But they're both year-to-date figures. So I also want to see somehow a little bit of trend. And for that we use a spark line. So let's see in Excel how we can create this. So we're back in our file. We need to have the two top 10 lists over here. And the data is prepared, of course. Here we have our customer top 10. And the trick I did is that I use the top 10 functionality of Excel, of the pivot table. In the filter, you can choose a top 10, and that's what we did. So that means that I always have 10 values, and then I use a lookup function, index function, to get the data replicated over here so that I can paste it into my dashboard. And I need some supporting data of the last 12 months for the spark lines. So the spark lines is the first object we're going to create. It should go over here, so I'm going to select the trend column. And then I say insert a spark, not a spark line, but a column spark line. And then it wants to know where is the data located. So the nice thing that you can do with a spark line is you can select a whole group. And then you select the data that goes with it. There we are. And it will create the spark lines. And what is very nice is that the spark lines are now organized in a group. So I can change the properties of the spark lines with one step. And I want to have a different color. The ugly one. There we are. I think for this one, we can also use this one. So that's the spark line. And then we're going to treat it exactly the same as we did with the P&L table. I'm going to select it. We're going back to the dashboard. I position my cursor. And again, I paste it as a linked picture. And I adjust the size a little bit. There we are. And now we have to do the same for the product top 10. We select the trend column again. We insert our spark line. Select the data. Adjust the color. And copy the table. Back to our dashboard. And we paste it again as a linked picture. And as final step, we have to adjust the size a little bit. Oh. There we are. So we're almost done now. So we're almost there. All the charts are filled. There's one trouble. There's one problem. To the right, we have a white empty place for a legend. And that's something you can figure out yourself how you can copy that in. The hint that I will give you is you can also use a linked picture. And if you look in the file, you will find a sheet that is labeled legend where you find an area that you can copy. And the other thing you have to do is you have to clean up the colors a little bit, because this is looking very ugly. We only needed that to visualize our grid, but this is how we would like to see it. So we want to have some gray background behind the graphs, and all the other colors should go, and we see our legend to the right. And that brings us to the end of this series of videos. We have two surprises for you, two little bonuses that you can have a look at. But I would like to end with this slide, and that is, we spent a lot of time in doing all kinds of tricks and making a nice dashboard in Excel. But what is really important is that before you start doing anything in Excel, is that you really think, what is the information I need to present to the driver behind my dashboard? So I hope you enjoyed it. I hope to see some of you back in the bonus video, and otherwise, see you next time.